In this video, we will show you how to do integrals with Grassmann numbers. Grassmann numbers are an important concept in quantum field theory, where we use them to describe fermions. They are named after the German mathematician Hermann Grassmann. The special thing about Grassmann numbers is that they do not commute. For usual numbers, 4 times 3 is the same as 3 times 4, but for two Grassmann numbers, theta 1 and theta 2, their product is not the same if we exchange them. In order to discuss integration with Grassmann numbers, let's start with a very simple example of just one Grassmann number, which we will call theta. Since theta times theta must be equal to negative theta times theta, this product must be zero. Therefore, any function of this single Grassmann number can only look like this, where we have one constant term and one term with theta. Any higher terms like theta squared or theta cubed are zero because theta is a Grassmann number. Taking a derivative works just like the usual derivative, such that here only a1 remains. If we have more than one Grassmann number, we have to change their order until the derivative and the number it's acting on are right next to each other. So what about integration? In order to see how this works, we require three things. First, the integration should be linear, so we can split the integration along a plus sign and can also put constants in front of the integral. Second, we want that integration over Grassmann numbers is invariant under translations. This is because we want to use them in quantum field theory, where such a behavior is very convenient. And third, the output of an integral should not depend on the integration variable, or in other words, the output should just be a regular number. Now let's see how these conditions help us. From the second one, translational invariance, we can get the following equation, where a0, a1, and b can be any complex number. Then, from the first condition, linearity, we know that we can split up the integral into several integrations. Since this must hold for any values of b, the integral over 1 must be 0. Since there is no b on the right-hand side of the equation. That's already a very interesting result. The third condition states that the output of an integral is a regular number. If we start with the general function f of theta, we can already say that the first term will be 0, since the integral over 1 is 0. Then a1 times the integral over theta must be equal to some number c, or the integral must be equal to c over a1. This c is now usually defined to be equal to a1, which is like a normalization condition for Grassmann integrals, such that the integral over theta is 1. In conclusion, the integration over Grassmann numbers works exactly the same as taking a derivative. This has lots of interesting applications in quantum field theory when we consider fermions, but that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.